Dickinson's poem, Because I Could Not Stop for Death, is one of her most well-known works. This six-stanza poem is written in standard ballad meter, with the exception of the first two lines of the fourth stanza. In the poem, the speaker takes a metaphorical journey, accompanied by death, personified as a gentleman who picks the speaker up in a carriage, occupied by him and immortality. Because she has neither the time nor the inclination to stop for death, the personified death unexpectedly and kindly stops for her. Having put aside her work and her leisure, her worldly pursuits, she rides in the carriage as it moves slowly, passing familiar, realistic scenes of town life, school children, grain growing, and the sun setting. When they pass the setting sun, they seem to come to a halt, for the speaker realizes he, the sun, passed us. At that very moment, she becomes aware of feeling cold, and then comes upon a grave. By the end of the final stanza, she realizes what first seemed like an unthreatening carriage ride has brought her to an eternal state of non-being. One of Dickinson's most famous poems, Because I Could Not Stop for Death, takes a clear-eyed view of death and dying. At first, death is personified as a polite gentleman, not a grim antagonist. He kindly stops for the speaker, and they leave together in a carriage along with immortality, implying the end of life will lead to the immortality of the soul. The journey begins slowly, and because death has been so civil, the speaker feels no threat or fear, for the speaker has willingly put away worldly occupations, and although caught unaware, is ready for it. In the third stanza, the two pass sights that suggest three stages of life: school children playing, fields of grain, and the setting sun. In the fourth stanza, however, the speaker corrects herself, saying the sun passed the carriage instead of the other way around. This statement suggests the speaker has died, for she and the carriage has ceased to move. In the fifth stanza, they pause before what seems like a grave, a house that seemed a swelling of the ground, with only the roof visible. In the final stanza, the speaker is alone. Death is not mentioned, nor is immortality. Centuries have passed, but the speaker no longer experiences the passage of time, as do the living. So it seems to have been only a day since she first guessed the horses were headed toward eternity.